Hello, I see that I have one person. Hello, could you tell me who you are? So today I'm doing a live demo on fondant frills or ruffles, also called deckle edge fondant. It's very thin and it kind of looks like the edging of paper, like the kind of paper with the rough edges, and that's called deckling or deckled. So that's why in my video, I have five people here. Hi, everybody. In my video, hi, Rachel. You guys can take a minute and tell me who you are, where you're from. So you're from Canada. Diana, or Donna, hi Donna, hi, Donna G. Danielle Alvarez, hi. So, hello, Jay Niles. Okay, so this weekend I have a wedding cake and it's a fondant frill cake. Hi from Ohio, Ronak. Sorry, my eyes are not too good. Delania, hi Delania from Texas. So if you guys have questions about fondant at all at the end, you can ask me questions. In general about fondant, but today I'm going to just show you, because I have a wedding cake this weekend, it's three tiers of fondant ruffles. Hi, Carrie. And this is the first one I've done, actually, a wedding cake. I did a 6-inch sample cake of this about a few months ago, in July, actually, and I have a video on YouTube if you want to watch it. Now, in that video for the ruffles, I actually hand did them. Hi from Belize, wow, Parlette. So I hand rolled those out in the video. For this cake, I didn't want to have to roll everything out by hand. So I did get some help. Hi, Laura. Here is the pasta maker that I got. Actually, a friend of mine loaned it to me. And I'm going to use that. That's going to save me a lot of time and effort. Because I've already tried it this morning and it does work. It's wonderful. So first a little bit about fondant. So I love Fondorific, and I've used all the different ones. I also love Satin Ice. Wilton is okay, and I have made homemade fondant as well, but it's a lot of labor, so I just buy it at this point. Yeah, I love this pasta roller too. It's great. Thanks, Rachel. All right, so I guess I'll just get right into it and show you guys how I do this. I'm going to move the camera. Maybe a little closer. Oh, okay. Bye-bye. So here's my pasta roller. I have a little bit of fondant. Now you just need a little bit for each ruffle. Hi, Beth. Thanks for being here. Thank you everybody for being here. This is awesome, I love it. Cornstarch. So the cornstarch is gonna help to keep the fondant from sticking to the roller and also to the surface. And I have a little bit of, let me just change the angle a little bit here. Sorry about this. I really need to have a photographer. I want to make it closer so you guys can see. So I've got some cornstarch here, got my roller, and my piece of fondant. The cake that I'm going to be doing is a 9-inch cake for the demo. And I'm going to go ahead and put that through. Now I have this set at probably an eighth of an inch, and I wouldn't want to go any thinner than that. That's pretty thin. It's pretty soft, but it does stick to your cake. So I have a buttercream frosted cake, and I'm going to bring that over here right now. And as you can see, I already put one on. And you want it to come up a little higher than the edge of the cake. So for the next piece, I'm going to use a little bit of water to attach it to the fondant, to attach it to this fondant here. So I've got a little bit of water here, not too much. Just enough to stick this on. And then it sticks to the buttercream. This cake's making me nervous. Okay, because this is gonna be a huge cake. Then what I do is I use this tool here and my fingers, and I just do some ruffles like that. Not too much ruffle, just a little bit. And that's it. It's actually, I don't like the way this looks right here. I don't know if you can see it. So I'm going to kind of ruffle that over to kind of hide that. And what I'll do is the next layer, I will hide this. It's kind of a lump here from the other fondant. Then once this dries, I'm using a copper petal dust, and I'm going to mix that with a little bit of almond extract. And I'm just going to paint the edges once it dries. So you might need a little help to keep them on in the beginning. Just kind of hold it on there. And then you just work your way around the cake. This is a lot of work. So for those of you who are making cakes for a living, you definitely want to charge enough to do something like this. This is going to take me quite a bit of time. Actually, I think that's a little too high. I'm probably going to fix that. I'll probably take that off and redo. But you get the idea. So do you guys have any questions? Or would you like me to do another one? So who here has done one of these kind of cakes before? Or are thinking about doing one? Anybody? Hi, Bernice. Or Berenice, how much work time will you have? So for almost every wedding cake I do, this one's going to be a little longer, I figure about 10 hours from start to finish. Oh yeah, Beth, so did you do them by hand? Because I did the first one, I rolled them by hand, and then I used a pizza cutter. And that actually worked really well for a small cake, for a 6-inch cake. It still took me at least probably 45 minutes or more to do that cake, maybe an hour to cover that cake, that little tiny 6-inch cake. How many layers was that cake and how much do you... Yes, I used the cutter that I had from Wilton. So, okay. That cake is 3 layers high with... And each layer is probably an inch, so inch and a half maybe. And then the filling is probably half an inch, something like that. I did raspberries and white chocolate buttercream in that one. And it's about, I don't have my measuring stick right here, but it's at least 6 inches high. And the whole cake, each tier is pretty high like that. I like to do the high cakes. Any more questions? I used to do 2 layers and then a thick filling. But I think after seeing all the cakes on Facebook and YouTube and the taller ones, it looks better, I think. Hold on, guys, I gotta plug my camera in. Are you going to color any of the frosting? I think that's what it said. No. This cake is going to be all white and it's going to have flowers. Yeah, it's just going to be white, Beth. I didn't like the flavor of Wilton and threw it away. Are any better in flavor? Yes, Fonderific actually tastes good. Taller ones look better. That cake, 6 inches in diameter. That cake is actually 8 inches or 9 inches in diameter and at least 6 inches high. So it does take a little more time to cover a cake like that and more stuff. But yeah, each wedding cake, I figure at least 10 hours per wedding cake. So when I figure out a price, I use that 10 hours. For this cake, I had to charge extra because I knew this was going to be more work and more stuff. Can you guys hear me okay? Because I just plugged in my phone with my, the battery was low. And I don't have my speaker on. Okay, thanks, Donna. Marcella, yes. Okay, cool. Hi, Rachel. Awesome. So, any more questions? When you are doing a cake like this, do you put it in the fridge as you were working on it? I actually am going to be putting this in the fridge. So this cake, I baked it yesterday. I froze the layers and then I filled it while they were still cold, and then the filling gets firm, and then I usually put it back in the fridge. And yes, the ruffles do harden actually. And then I take it out of the fridge, crumb coat it, frost it, and in this case I'm going to do the ruffles and then I'm going to stick it back in the fridge and it's going to stay there until the wedding. So the sample cake that I did, which was 6 inches, I refrigerated it for days and tested it out to make sure that the fondant was going to be okay. And then I froze it because I wanted to really like try different things to see if it works. I froze it, took it out of the freezer, and actually that softened up the fondant because it had that moisture from the freezer when it started to come to room temperature. And then we actually used it for a birthday cake for a friend. It was fine. It was perfectly fine and it was easy to cut. I was a little worried about cutting. When the bride initially ordered the cake, I was very nervous about how they were going to cut the cake. I leave it unwrapped. When I froze it, I wrapped it. How many days do you prepare? On Wednesday, generally. You're welcome, Beth. And then I will try to finish the cakes by Thursday or Friday. So the wedding's usually on a Saturday, sometimes a Sunday. But I try to get everything done on Friday so I can relax. And the cakes are fine. They're actually, they get better with age. And freezing cakes really helps. So let's see, what else? What else would you like to know about fondant? Anything? I used to make my own fondant, but I think I already told you, I can't deal with that anymore, so I just buy it. You're welcome, Marcella. Yeah, I'll do another ruffle. That's a good idea. So I've got some fondant out. This is a great tool if you don't have one. These are awesome. These little cornstarch pouches. So I don't want to put too much in there because I don't want it to be too long. I'll tell you, I'm not really looking forward to doing the big bottom part of the bottom tier. And then I'm just getting a little powdered sugar on there because I don't want it to stick to the machine. And then I'm going to put it right in there. This one came out a little rough, so you can smooth it out. And if you want to, at this point, you could give it some shape. I'm going to go ahead and cut it, actually. Because I like it when they come down. And it gives this little edge. You could even give it a ruffle like that. It's pretty cool because it's very random. You don't have to, you know, you don't really want to make it look perfect. You want to make it look kind of a little on the rustic side. Let me grab the cake. And then a little bit of water. And then give it the ruffle. There. It doesn't look like much yet, but what I'll do is I'm gonna finish off this cake and I'll take a picture of it and put it on, you know, I'll put it online so you guys can see the finished product. All right, I am going to just move over to my computer so I can see if I'm missing any questions. All right, so there are some things here. Can you do salute? I have one that's great. Do you only use cornstarch or a mixture with confectionery sugar? I like to just use the cornstarch. And half corn. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's fine. The sugar tends to get sticky. So, I mean, if it's on the, I don't know. I've had some issues with the confectionery sugar in the past. I used to use the confectionery sugar and then I discovered that the cornstarch works better for me. So Beth is in my cake crew. I love talking about my cake crew, on Facebook. If anybody's interested, let me know. Where can I get that cornstarch bag? What is it called? I don't know what the proper name is. It's in my Amazon shop. So if you go below the video here, you'll see a link to my Amazon store, and I have everything there that I use. So you can just click on it and buy it. And I don't get paid a lot for that. And you don't have to pay more for that. Just makes it easier for you to find what you need. So Wedding Cakes for You, Amazon, it's down below. Oh, it's called a Pounce. Really? Oh, wow. I didn't know that. Any more questions? Fondant tools. Beth loves our group. Yay! So I have a group on Facebook. I have two groups. One is a customers only group, and that's the Cake Crew, or Lorelei's Cake Crew. And Beth is in the Cake Crew. Thanks, Beth. So to be a customer, you just go to Amazon and buy my book. Wedding Cakes with Lorelai Step by Step, and then you can be in the group. But you have to contact me and let me know that you bought the book, because I have no way of knowing from Amazon who bought the books. And then just email me and I'll let you into the crew. And then I have a Facebook group. It's not non-customers, it's open, it's public, and you can find that on Facebook. It's called Cakes by You. And that's a very new group. $5 at Walmart, cool. Yeah, Walmart actually is becoming much better as far as cake decorating supplies. And I do go there to get my, the fondant, actually. What's it called? The Fondorific. Has anyone here tried the Fondorific? Who uses Satin Ice? Because I like the Satin Ice. But if I need something quick and I happen to be around Walmart, I'll just go in there and grab some stuff. They have like little packages of different colored fondants. Satin Ice, yeah. I like Satin Ice a lot. Wilton really doesn't taste very good. I know that. It's terrible. So I imagine when they cut the wedding cake, a lot of people are going to peel that off. So, hi, Carrie. Carrie's also in the crew. Awesome. So, yeah, what kind do you make, Carrie? Do you make the marshmallow fondant or the other kind? Mona Lisa, I've never even heard of that one. Huh, I'll check that one out. There's so many brands. And I also find it, I like to buy the colored if possible. If I'm using colored fondant, I don't like the mess of coloring fondant. Hi, Cakes Aboard Da Sol. Sorlen, I can't even read that, sorry. All right, well, I heard about that. Or Kara, you told me about that. A recipe where it has cream in it. I also haven't tried it yet, but the butter, like the buttercream fondant, I guess it's just buttercream with tons of sugar in it. That would be very tasty. I'm going to have to try that one. Yeah, Kara, you had mentioned a recipe by somebody. Where's that recipe so people can find it? Well, I like to keep this to 20 minutes and it's been 22. So if you guys have more questions, you can ask them after and I will come back in and answer any questions that you have that I can help you with on fondant. Oh, Vina Asmanov, that's right. Yep. All right, everybody. So thank you so much for being here. I hope that helped. And you're welcome, Beth. And Carrie, you're going to be doing some ruffles as well, right? Don't you have, didn't you just get one of those pasta makers? Sorry, my battery's going. All right, well, I'm going to say goodbye, guys. And I'll see you next. I try to do this every Wednesday around the same time. All right. Thank you so much. Bye, Donna.